Five Nights at Freddy's has been a staple in internet culture for nearly 10 years now, spawning some of the most dedicated followers to dig deep into the lore surrounding it. But what if I told you that every theory you ever knew was wrong? Today, we change that. Everypony, welcome to Main Theory, the only show where you can kick your hooves back and relax while I explain the intricacies of why horses can actually be purple. And speaking of purple, let's talk about a purple horse. No, not that one. That one. Ah yes, Starlight Glimmer, a fan favorite throughout the latter seasons of My Little Pony. But what if I told you that today, I could prove to you that Starlight is still holding back secrets that no pony knows about? That's right, our old cutie mark stealing friend has a little more than just thievery on her hooves. And it all starts with a different franchise, Five Nights at Freddy's. Five Nights at Freddy's has been known to have an extensive amount of lore chalked up behind it, spanning across multiple games, books, and of course, the fandom theories. However, all of these theories forget to mention one thing. My Little Pony, friendship is magic. You see, many a fan subscribes to the old purple guy canon, the man behind the slaughter, if you will. You see, this is where I'd have to differ. I don't think it was a purple guy at all. In fact, I can prove to you that the purple guy isn't even William Afton. Actually, the purple guy isn't even a guy. Would you believe me if I said that it was, in fact, a purple mare? And I don't mean just any mare. That's right, I'm talking about Starlight Glimmer. Remember earlier when I was talking about how she had more than thievery on her hooves? I wasn't kidding. Go ahead and add kidnapping and murder to those lists of equestrian crime. Now, I know what you might be thinking.
Lara, what kind of nonsensical rambling are you on about?
Hush. I can explain. In episode 2 of season 5, The Cutie Map Part 2, there is an encounter when the villagers of Our Town, strange cult name I know, confront Glim Glam of her lying nature regarding cutie marks. This is the important moment we hear this.
Everything else I said is true. The only way to be happy is if we're all equal.
Except for you.
Does that sound a little familiar? Allow me to refresh your memory. That's right, Starlight Glimmer and Springtrap share the same noise of anger, but this is where I'm going to blow your mind. What if Starlight Glimmer was Springtrap? Going back to earlier when I was talking about how Starlight Glimmer was the mare behind the slaughter, we can actually notice quite a lot of similarities between both characters. Similarity 1, both are purple. I mean, come on, every pony, it's on the nose. Similarity 2. Both share the exact same anger jump scare noise. This is clearly not a coincidence. Similarity 3. Both are very troubled individuals. Starlight essentially enslaved a whole village of people. I don't think it's too far out of reality to say that she did a few more nefarious activities on the side. And for perhaps my most impactful piece of evidence, the episode Rock Solid Friendship. You see, pizza is not brought up at all in Friendship is Magic, aside from one major episode. See, in Rock Solid Friendship, we can see Pinkie Pie delivering a pizza to Derpy, but who else do we see in this very scene? That's right, Starlight Glimmer! And I must say, she looks rather unpleased to see Pinkie Pie with pizza. I'll get more into that later. Now, all of this begs the question, what does this mean for the rest of the FNAF lore? Well, buckle up, because we're throwing all of your previous knowledge out the window. William Afton, Starlight Glimmer. Henry Emily, co-founder of Freddy Fazbear's Pizza, Trixie Lulamoon. Michael Afton, Luster Dawn. I mean, there is really no cracks here in the surface, people. This theory has no content.
Looking for some pony? Is that the best you got?
Wait, rewind that? No, it can't be. So it turns out that both the Changelings and Starlight Glimmer are the purple mares behind the slaughter. Or purple bugs? Can a horse be two horses, or...
The Tantivus also makes the springtrap jump scare noise, Larrivan. And it's purple!
Since we know Starlight Glimmer is a serial murderer with absolutely no competition, it's safe to say that she has been doing a good job at hiding her true nature behind the mask of being a school principal. Though, what if I told you that the School of Friendship wasn't actually a school? What if I told you that it was actually Freddy Fazbear's new Mega Pizzaplex location run by none other than President Starlight Purple Mare Glimmer? These kids don't care about learning, they care about pizza. And what better place for Starlight to lure children in than a giant pizza megaplex? Listen, everypony, I am a completely sane individual and I really don't think that this theory is incorrect. I mean, come on, does this really seem like some pony who isn't trustworthy?
Five Nights at Freddy's, is this where you wanna be? I just don't get it.
With all of these facts having been lined up, it really does get you thinking. One lore piece in particular is... You see, one could say the bite victim was Jeremy Fitzgerald. Incorrect, actually. I am more than confident in saying the victim of the bite of 87 was none other than Pinkie Pie doing her usual routine shifts. Sorry, Pinkie. Such an awful thing to happen to a party pony. But I mean, it makes sense when you think about it. I mean, remember earlier when I brought up rock solid friendship? Pinkie Pie is literally wearing a pizza slice. Even after losing her frontal lobe, she still has unwavering fealty to Starlight Glimmer. I'd go as far to say that the reason Pinkie Pie acts the way she does in the show is because of the fact her frontal lobe was bitten off. Now, if we're talking about the bite of 83, that's a whole other story of pony madness in and of itself. But let's rewind a little bit. What about the spirits that possess the animatronics? Who were the foals that fell victim to Starlight's evil clutches? While it's hard for me to say who exactly, I can say two foals are for certain. Diamond Tiara and Twist. There's a reason why we don't see Diamond Tiara at all in later seasons of the show, outside of her occasional ghostly apparition, of course. And as for Twist, she is the embodiment of the nerd emoji, so it's pretty safe to say she didn't get very far. Let us take a moment to remember both of their sacrifices. Suffice to say, we really need to lock Starlight up for her crimes. I am more than happy to have brought this attention onto her for all of you to see. Starlight must be stopped before she can murder more innocents. Actually, can we wait to arrest her until after I get my pizza? I paid good bids for the pie and I am really hungry. But hey, that's just a theory. A main theory. Thanks for watching.
Hey everypony, I just wanted to give a quick thank you to everyone who has been supporting me from the beginning. Thank you to all of the members who have been supporting me throughout on Ko-Fi and just helping out in general with everything that I've been doing here over on the channel. None of this would be possible without any of you guys, so genuinely from the bottom of my heart, thank you. Oh, and aside from that, here's my website. I am available for hire and I'm willing to carry on MatPat's legacy. I can't think of any more pony qualified than me. Anyway, until next time, go be a main theory or something. I don't know. Bye-bye.